today I'm going to be doing my favorite movies and shows of 2018. So I've never done this before. I always do favorite books, but I've never done favorite movies and TV shows. But in 2018, I decided to set a goal to watch more movies because I noticed that I would read like a bajillion books in a year, but then I would watch like two movies. And I really wanted to change that. And I did. In 2018, I think I managed to watch like 50 movies, which is a lot, but I also read 75 books, so to put that in context, there's not that many. Also wanted to talk about TV shows, and I'm gonna start with that first because there's not that many. First, I want to talk about The Mindy Project. I binge watched all of The Mindy Project in like 2 weeks, and I did this earlier in the year. I believe it was in April/March, and it quickly became one of my all-time favorite shows ever. I love The Mindy Project so much. I recently just rewatched the show. It hasn't even been a year since I watched The Mindy Project for the first time, and I rewatched it again because that's just how much I love the show. I love the humor of the show. It's amazing. Every episode is hilarious. I laugh so much. I love all of the characters of The Mindy Project. All of the characters are so iconic. Morgan, Mindy Lahiri, Danny Castellano, all of them are amazing. I love that Mindy directs, writes, stars in The Mindy Project. She's so freaking talented. I love her. Wish The Mindy Project was still on. Next, Victorious Season 2. I watched Victorious Season 2 this year, and oh my god, I love the show so much. It's made by Masterpiece on PBS, and Jenna Coleman, aka Clara Oswald from Doctor Who, stars in Victoria. Oh my god, when I first found out about the show, I was so freaking excited. Queen Victoria is one of my favorite queens ever. I love studying her reign in British history. This is definitely one of those shows that is not very much for the general audience. It's very much catered to a very specific type of people who are like into history and slow-moving historical drama. It's very character-driven, and there's not that much plot, and a lot of the plot is very much directed around the history of the time, but I still love it so much. Oh my god, the costumes are amazing. Every time I watch an episode, I'm like, where can I get all of these costumes, because they're so beautiful. Whoever designs the costumes for Victoria should get like a million awards. And I love how this show not only follows Victoria's personal life and her struggles as being the queen, but we also get all of the behind the scenes of the servants. We get to know a lot of the servants in the castle and their backstories, and there's also times where we just see England in general, things that are happening in England and how the English people are dealing with Victoria's reign. And I love that. I love that we see all aspects of England during this time, not just Victoria. Obviously, the show is focused on Victoria, but you get to see so many other things, and I love that about this show. It's starting again very, very soon, and I'm so excited for season 3. Last, I rewatched Charmed this year. Oh my gosh, Charmed. I haven't seen it in like 10 years. Oh my god, it's been a long time. But I had so much fun rewatching this show this year. I love it so, so, so much. It's one of my all-time favorite shows ever, and I'm so happy I rewatched it. I was so shocked how well I remembered so many of the episodes. I had the best time rewatching Charmed. I know I'm gonna rewatch it time and time again. And now we're gonna get into movies. Oh my gosh, 2018 was the year of book to movie adaptations. So many book to movie adaptations came out, and not only did so many come out, but a lot of them were amazing. So number one, I mean number 10. I'm going in order when I watch these, not necessarily my favorites, although this would probably be my number one favorite. Love, Simon. It came out in the beginning of the year, and I've seen it twice, technically three times, probably four times. Honestly, like, I've lost track. I've seen it all the way through two times, but I've also seen parts of it three or four times, and some things in the movie are different, but I don't care. The movie was just done so well, and it was so cute and adorable, and I loved every second of it, and I now want to go rewatch it just talking about it. This is everything a YA book to movie adaptation needs to be, and I'm so happy that we're getting such amazing adaptations like Love, Simon. I cannot wait for more adaptations like this. I watched Black Panther, another one I watched twice. Oh my gosh, you know, I actually prefer DC to Marvel. I know that's an unpopular opinion, but I really, really loved Black Panther. The technology of Black Panther and the whole concept of Wakanda being this secret society that's super technologically advanced, but nobody knows that outside. So fascinating. I love all the lore and mythology of the world and all the characters, and the actors and casting was amazing. Every single person they cast in the roles was absolutely perfect for the roles, and they did so well. Next, Ocean's 8. I was so excited for this movie because the cast for it was amazing. My favorite, my queen, Mindy Kaling was in it, and Sandra Bullock was in it. Awkwafina was in it, which I almost forgot about. Rihanna was in it. Anne Hathaway was also in Ocean's 8. Okay, the cast was amazing, and I love the whole heist and seeing them prep for everything. It was such a fun movie and I loved it so much. Paddington 2. Okay, so this is not like a blockbuster movie, but honestly, like, Paddington 2 made me so happy. I loved this movie. I loved the first movie and I knew I was gonna love the second one, but this is such like a great feel-good movie. It was such a sweet story and I loved it, and I hope they make more Paddington movies. To All the Boys I Loved Before. This was one of the best book-to-movie adaptations that I have ever seen. I've also Love, Simon. I've seen it twice all the way through, but there's also been a couple of scenes that I've seen like 3 or 4 times. This adaptation was absolutely amazing. Yeah, they did change a couple things, but I don't care. It was such a well-done movie, and I'm so happy and satisfied with this movie. I'm so happy we're finally getting the book-to-movie adaptations that we deserve for the YA community, because there's been some really crappy ones, but this one was one of the absolute best, and I know I'm gonna be rewatching and rewatching it forever, and we got a confirmed sequel! Which means John Ambrose McLaren. I'm so excited. Next, another book-to-movie adaptation, Crazy Rich Asians. I saw this movie twice in the theaters. That's how much I loved it. I love this movie so much. I think I even like it better than the book. They did change a couple things in the movie, which kind of like pissed me off, but they did in the movie so well that I don't care. The movie was so fun. I love the soundtrack. The book translated so well onto film. The humor was spot on. It's a perfect movie to adapt, and it was great to watch. Next, West Side Story. I know this is my first time out watching West Side Story. It's one of those iconic Broadway shows that for some reason I never watched, but it's a Romeo and Juliet retelling. I'm so happy I finally watched it. I loved it so much. I don't know what I love more about West Side Story. The music, the dancing. I love the music so much. I'm still like singing the music all the time. My favorite song is Tonight, and I also love Maria. I watched the movie version in the 60s. And last but not least, another book to movie adaptations. Again, this year we were blessed with so many amazing book to movie adaptations, and that is The Hate U Give. This movie was so good. It was so accurate to the book, and it got all of the feeling and emotion of the book, and it was so intense. The casting, oh my gosh, the casting was amazing. I loved every single character, oh my god, especially Maverick. Like, was so Maverick. I don't know, they couldn't have cast a better person to play Maverick. His acting was just exactly the way I pictured Maverick acting in the book, and Amanda Sternberg was amazing. They were such a perfect casting role for this. I think this is their best role I've ever seen them in. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed. Comment down below, what was your favorite movie or TV show of 2018? Did you watch all the book to movie adaptations that came out this year? Did you enjoy them? What did you think? Comment that down below. My social media links are all down below. My Twitter, my Bookstagram, my Goodreads. Arrivederci!